Okay, well, fellas, we're here. We had a meeting in here in the SussHut, of course, here. We had a session in the SussHut here in Alice in the Eastern Cape of Southern Africa. There was a lot of people there. How many people came last night?
11.
11 people. Okay. Well, introduce yourselves. Tell people who's talking and what did you accomplish last night? What was the session about?
The session was my name is Khaya. My last name is Gona. I'm staying around Limbeto location. I'm 29 years old. I'm part and parcel of the SussHut. We were having a session yesterday, and our agenda, well, we were first introducing the guys who were the first time coming yesterday.
Coming to the SussHut for a session.
Yes.
And the sessions are think tank sessions. Okay, so yes. What happened? What did you get out of it?
So we were having guys coming from Timbaza as well.
So Dimbaza is about 45 minutes away from here.
Yes, okay, yes.
Okay.
It's 45, yes. So we actually introduce ourselves, meeting each other, talking to each other, giving some details. So we also went to the point of altcoin trader, and how do we open it, and what do we need to open it, and when are we gonna make sure that the other guys who were not opened will, since they were open to the
wallets,
the wallets.
Oh, so you're learning about cryptocurrencies.
Cryptocurrency, yes. We as well engage with the new guys who are coming in this location. Mm-hmm. So we, from those from Timbaza, we're meeting with these guys in here in Limbete. And step number two, what was step number two? Can you proceed now?
Yeah, step number two, it was about, it's the why people they are here in the SussHut.
Yes.
Why people attend these think tank sessions in the SussHut?
What do their vision get out of the SussHut?
Yes.
And then what do they want to achieve in the SussHut?
So really we haven't been gone we haven't really accomplished anything or did anything
yet.
So these are just projections.
Of course, people, we must know why people are there here and then what they want to accomplish while they are here.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You see. So the other thing is, as we are here at the SussHut, and then we have some kind of talks. After we have talks yesterday, we try to understand people. They were trying to understand the crypto currency thing, and we were trying to explain. And then, so people now they must have more information by themselves and dig.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because this thing is not somebody's thing; it's everybody's thing. Because this thing is worldwide.
Mm-hmm.
So this idea that came up to the SussHut is very, very, very important, because this is a starting point. You remember Bitcoin starting point was so light, and then people, they didn't consider that Bitcoin will be there. So this crypto thing, this node that we are talking about, that node is very important, because the node is new on the market.
Mm-hmm.
So people, they need to consider to go in while they can afford it.
Mm-hmm.
Because that thing, on the long run, when the currency crumble,
mm-hmm.
everything is gonna be digital.
Mm-hmm.
So people, they must put their brave minds there. They must think of the future, because not think of the money, think of the future,
mm-hmm.
and then the investment and how to safeguard yourself to the community. Because what, after a while, if this thing is worldwide, and then the currency, the other currencies crumbles.
Mm-hmm.
You see, everything is gonna be uptight. Nobody's gonna be accessible to us to be a part of this. While this thing is accessible to us, we must make sure, as the youth, we make sure that we become a part of it, and then we also give the information to the other people that they need them the most.
Mm-hmm.
You see.
Mm-hmm. So folks have to do their own research, you know, and then get on board. They can't come to you and say, give me advice, I'll do whatever you say.
Because it became so very hard for this guy to understand what's the reason of opening this wallet. So we will tell them, if you need more information, go to the internet, go research, and we'll try to, by all means, to bring the paper,
the pamphlets. I wanna tell them, because I'm gonna try to take the history of Bitcoin, the main coin, Bitcoin, and then I take the from where it started till now, so that they can see how it does it go, because the Bitcoin have a starting point, man, and then it goes up till to a certain peak, and then it goes down. Because the coin can't just go and fall at the very same time. So while the coin is at the starting point, it's very, very advantageous for everybody to start.
That's why you're doing this these notes.
Yeah, these notes. Mm. Because we didn't take the notes that are already there. They're in the starting point. So the graph always go like this.
But the question is going to become, you know, how do you know this note is safe? There's a lot of coins that came up between the time Bitcoin started and now. Why do you pick this particular node? Why do you want to open this particular wallet? Why do you think?
The thing is, that's why we open this particular node is legit, just like the other nodes that are following the Bitcoin. Mm-hmm. Because if it was not legit, we won't be even finding it on Altrade. Because all those nodes that are under Altrade that are listed there, they are all safe. Mm-hmm. And then we have the history of the other nodes, because each and every node have its history there. Mm. When you are going to Altrade coin, there's something that you go to news, and then you pick up the history of each node.
So we have to hope that all the Altrade is not going to be corrupted before you start something. Oh, okay.
I think people are thinking that because when we open this wallet, there will be some money that we gotta like investing, go put it in. So people don't want to lose their money if they put money. What are the benefits? What are we gonna get? What is the safety and security of gold?
I have to say this because I'm in the same boat. Yeah. You know, we can't put money in because we ain't got no money to put in to lose. Exactly. We can't lose what you can't put in. So this, but really, you want to open a wallet. So you have something, when something happens, you can do something. And if you should get a little bit of stuff, you can put it in the wallet and just leave. In other words, if you can afford to get rid of this, if you can afford to spend this 20 Rand on putting it into this, rather than, I don't know, a bottle of, you know, whatever, or smokes or whatever.
And the convenient thing is, we should get into this to this torch while it's still
the starting point,
still. Mm. In the lower level, right?
Lower level, because everybody can afford it.
Mm. Yes.
Let's put it like
this. Right now they can afford it, but we don't know what's going to happen even.
Exactly.
Because I remember when Bitcoin started, and we did some things, but every time we talked, like a week later, it would go up so much.
Yeah, it's fluctuating.
Oh gosh, so we have to move ahead.
So people, they have this mentality, this is not a stock fail. You don't put money here. You put money in the wallet. There is no physical money that people will get on hand.
Yes.
Everything is gonna done digital. Mm-hmm. Whatever that you are concerned about is gonna be transparent, because whatever that you do digitally is gonna be transparent. Mm-hmm. Nobody's gonna hide. Yes. What I like about the digital currency, everything is transparent. Yes. After I will try to put a hint for them. They must learn about the blockchain. You see, but this is just the basic, because if you give them people like a lot of stuff, their head will be like boom, because the blockchain is also important. But they must first learn this is just the basic information. After we also talk about the SussHut, and then the meaning of the SussHut, also what is this? It's not the rule, the code. Code.
Yeah.
People, nobody is allowed to get in with drinks here.
Yes.
Nobody is allowed to get with food here. Nobody is allowed to come and smoke here. Because we are coming from outer world, going inside the heart.
Yeah.
The heart, there are so much stuff that the heart doesn't take.
Yes.
Mm. You see? So we must also like fix the mentality, our mentality. Mm. What you used to be, but when you are here, you must be.
You must be
normal.
Mm-hmm.
You see, because some other people, when they have other stuff outside, they don't behave because they are not normal. But when you are here, you must be in your state, at the right state.
Give the rest of your stuff outside, okay? Then.
So in other words, if this was a church, you'd be doing church code. If this was Shabin, you'd do Shabin code.
Yes,
this is SussHutt code.
Yes.
Okay, all right, I got you.
We as well talk about time. Just figure out that people don't take time. You know, everything has its own time. There's time for playing, there's time for everything, if you can ask me. So we talk to these guys. If we say we come in here at 5 o'clock, we let's try all be here by 5 o'clock, so that we can have an extra time if we can.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I saw them yesterday. They took time for granted. But if you don't take time seriously, everything will fall apart.
Yeah. Well, talking about time, I think it's time we need to go down, get to these computers, and give people to open their wallets or whatever have you.
Yeah.
Because yes. I hear the hordes coming. Thanks for this time, and we'll see you another time.
Hey, and the session, the after time, after hours session, it was lit.
Oh, it was lit.
Because we have the session, the normal session that everybody has.
The SussHutt think tank session.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then we have the outer SussHutt think tank session in the house.
You was in the house. It was about four people? Five?
Four people.
Okay.
Yeah, about four people.
You all talked for a long time.
Yeah.
For a long time, till 11 o'clock. Constructive stuff.
And again, let me thank Kodan for bringing those guys from Timbaza. Thanks, man. You made me proud. We need more people. We need to engage. We have to make this work for us, for the community, and for South Africa, and for the whole world. Right?
You know what?
Yeah.
Don't tell me about those guys, because those guys, they will always come around.
Yes.
But
yes.
The thing is, we must make sure the people of this place, they know what is happening. Because you see,
the main
people are the people of this place.
Because they must
take care of themselves. We mustn't wait for the other people who come from other places make change to us.
Yeah.
But those people, when they come here, they must know, okay, these people, they know what they are about here.
Yes.
You see?
Yes.
Because that thing of the other people, they come to give you stuff. When those people are not here, I'm like, we are not even come. No, it's not about me, it's about us. It's not about the Timbaza people, it's about everybody.
Yes, yes,
you see?
Yes.
Because it's about youth, because we are here for change, all of us.
Yes.
You see? Oh, did you introduce
and the yourself? Other thing we were talking about opening up Facebook, London, and YouTube.
Yeah, we will open all those. All those, but everybody must be aware.
For publicizing,
must be aware. Everybody must be aware.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I'm Masixole. My clan name is Ujola. Umwanya umpangebo umpango umthola umthwakazi umfazi benye phesha kwetsitsi. My grandma is Uzieka, Uzondi, Usambu, Khuta, Ucekiso, Uthambo, Lenyoka,
Ehlabela Umzondana.
And then I go to my father's, who's Umtande, Ungqulumsila, Usopicho, Mfuvela, Bambhensele. So let me go to my great father, is like Umpondo. It's Umpondo, it's what kind of name?
You mean Mpondo?
Mpondo, yeah. Mpondo. So let me go there because I know it.
Well, you're going to have to save for, another time.
Deep down.
Yeah.
You're going to
That's what lineage is about. There you go. Okay, thanks again.
Okay, thanks a lot.